So there are several ways to change a panel duration in the timeline view, both in frames and in seconds. So the first way is to go to the panel view in the duration field. You can see the current duration of the panel. So we know that it lasts for 30 frames, which is roughly 1.6 seconds, as this project is probably timed at 24 frames per second. So if we click in the field, we can change the time by typing in a new value and hitting enter. And immediately we saw that this light gray selected panel increased in length and all the subsequent panels were shifted down. You can also use the little arrows beside the time to change the duration as well. And of course, the duration in frames is updated just beside. Another way that you can change the duration is directly in the timeline view. If you bring your cursor down and hover between two panels, you'll notice that a double-headed arrow appears. You can then use it to click and drag between two panels to either shorten or lengthen that panel. And you'll notice that a black field appears with the current duration of the panel in seconds, as well as the difference between its current duration and its previous duration. So it's now 17 frames longer than it was. And this can work in the negative as well. However, if you find that you'd like to change the duration of a panel without affecting all of the other subsequent panels in your storyboard, you can do this by once again hovering your mouse on the line between two panels, but this time holding down the Alt button. And now as you drag, the only panel that you're going to affect is the panel directly after. So it will shorten or lengthen depending if you increase or decrease the duration of your selected panel.